Over the course of the last few episodes, we've been working on a Shapelayer accent library. I want to continue down the Shapelayer path, but we'll be doing something a little different. Today, I want to focus on text boxes. You'll definitely want to stick around for this tutorial where I'm going to show you how to create the only text box you'll ever need. There's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so the way that I've traditionally made text boxes, and you may have done the same, is by adding in a shape layer. I'm going to pull that underneath and then just adding in a simple rectangle with a fill. I'm going to change the color of that, and then we can resize our rectangle around our text box. There are expressions and even plugins that you can use that will size your box around your text, and also expressions that will resize your text box depending on the number of words, characters, lines, things like that. I actually have some tutorials where I show you how to do that. So this is the way I've always made text boxes. The main issue I have is with the animation part of it. So like if I wanted to animate this from the middle, which I normally wouldn't do, but this is the easiest way to animate it in. Let me put some speed on this. If you wanted it to come from one of the sides, hit Y to bring up your pan around tool. Now I have snapping enabled, which makes this a lot easier. Just drag this over to the left of your rectangle, call up your scale with S and then put a keyframe, make your X value 0, go forward about 20 frames, make that 100. But now what if I wanted to animate this box off to the right? Well, since my anchor point's over here, I can't really do that. One of the things I've actually done is add in a null object. So Shift Command Option Y, P for position, and then drag this over to the right side of your text box. And now you can parent your shape layer up to the null object, call up your scale, and you can actually animate this off. It's very effective. It gets the job done. And maybe you've done the same thing. There is a much, much easier way. And it's so obvious. I can't believe I never thought of it before, but I have stumbled upon it. And I'm going to show you how to do that right now. Add in a shape layer. Then I'm going to add in a path, which is going to call up your pen tool. Put a vertex to the left of your text. Hold down Shift and make another one to the right. And it really is this simple. Just add in a stroke, increase the stroke size, and you have a text box. Let's select both layers, hold down Command, and double click the pan around tool so that way anchor points are in the middle all around. P for position, and I like to take the position of my shape layer and just parent that to the position of my text. That way they're always linked. So of course, this only works if you're animating your text using text animators. If you'll be animating your text with the position transform setting, then obviously you don't want to parent the position of the text box to your text layer. Add in a group here. And I'm going to call this text box because we're going to make a text box and a text outline. So we take our path and our stroke, put it inside of our text box. Let's add in a trim paths. And this really is what makes the animation part a lot easier. We can animate our end percentage. This will come on from the left. If we want to go out to the right, just animate the start percentage. So instead of adding a null object and parenting things and moving anchor points, all you have to do is add a stroke, increase the stroke width, and add in trim paths. If for whatever reason you want to come in from the left and go back out to the left, you can do that as well. Just take your keyframes for your end percentage animation, copy paste, right click, keyframe assistant, and time reverse those. So now it will come on from the left and it goes back out to the left. I like to come in from one direction and go out to the other. I'm going to leave mine just like this. So that way it comes in from the left, goes out to the right. You can very easily, with the click of a button, change the direction. So now it comes in from the right, goes out to the left. So using a path instead of a rectangle just makes this so much easier. If you open up your stroke settings, you can change the butt cap to a round cap. So now you have a rounded text box. You can always increase the size of your stroke width, so that way it's as thick as you want, or if you want it to really hug your text, you can get it as tight as you want. And if you need to adjust this path whatsoever, all you gotta do is click on path, grab a vertex and move it, grab the other vertex, make sure you grab the vertex first, then hold down Shift, so that way it will snap to a straight line. Reset your anchor point by command double clicking your pan around tool, and it will snap right to your text layer again. If you're gonna do a text box, I highly recommend that you create a path and you adjust the stroke size settings. Not only can we make a text box like this, we can make a text outline in a very similar way. So let's take text box, we're gonna duplicate that. We're gonna call this text outline. with this layer selected, I'm going to type path. So it brings up my paths, and I'm just going to parent my text outline path to my text box path. So that way I only have to animate one path, and that's something that you may want to do. Makes life a lot easier. And then we also have our trim paths. So let's go ahead and link all of that up as well. So I'm going to take the start percentage of my text outline, go to my start of my text box, and same thing with end, get rid of those keyframes. So this is my text outline setting, but our keyframes and our path are going to be set from our text box. To me, it just makes it a lot easier to have one path and one set of keyframes to work with. Let's turn off our text box, and how do we make this a text outline? Okay, so let's open up our text outline and open up our stroke setting, and I just want to set my stroke to 10. This is going to be the size of the stroke I want to go around my text. So how do I get it to go around my text? Select text outline, go in here and add in an offset paths. So we open that up and we can increase the amount, and now we have an outline. Now stacking order is very important with shape layer tools. If we scrub through here, we can see this is not the kind of animation we want. We want the outline to go around our text. Take your offset paths and put it above your trim paths. Now we have an outline around our text. And I'm just going to hit U to bring up my keyframes to kind of spread these out a little bit more, so we have a little bit more room to kind of see exactly what's going on. Okay, so open up our text outline and open up our trim path settings right here. Adjust where you want your animation to begin. So you can adjust where you want it to start anywhere on this path. Now, if you notice, push in here, we can see that there's a little bit of a clipped edge right here. So one of the things I like to do with the stroke settings of my text outline, open up stroke, I like to make this a round cap so that way it rounds it right out, and then also make this a round join so all the corners match that as well. So I would recommend for your text outline, you just make the cap a round cap and the join a round join. And that's about it. So you can make a text box and a text outline by simply adding in a path and then adjusting your stroke width settings. You have full control over everything from stroke width size to your color on your text box and your text outline. Just remember to put your offset paths above your trim paths. And then you don't have to link up your path and your trim path settings. I like to do that, like I said, because I like to have only one set of variables to work with. I'm going to select P and just, I'm going to unlink this from my text layer. I'm going to put this back to 960, 540, and I'm going to make this an animation preset. Open it back up our shape layer and make sure that you select contents and transform, animation, save animation preset. And this will bring you to your documents, Adobe, the version. I'm in 2023, user presets. I'm going to 7-minute AE right here. Name this text box. Hit return to save it. We can get rid of this shape layer just to make sure that everything's saved okay. Go to our effects and presets and type in text underscore box. Make sure you don't have any layer selected and double click. Hit U to bring up your keyframes. And as you can see, those keyframes came in and we just put it underneath our text layer here. And there's our animated text box. So again, one of the things I like to do is take my position of my text box layer and just parent that to the position of the text layer I'm going to be using it for. The main thing you need to make sure is that both layers have centered anchor points. So select both layers, go to your toolbar, hold on command, and just double click the pan around tool. That way it puts them right in the middle. So of course, this only works if you're animating your text using text animators. If you'll be animating your text with the position transform setting, then obviously you don't want to parent the position of the text box to your text layer. And that's how you create the only text box you'll ever need. Let me know in the comments below if you've ever made text boxes like this. I've never made a text box myself with just a path and a stroke. I usually use a rectangle. But from here on out, I'll be using this preset. I'd like to thank the good folks over at AE Juice for sponsoring this video. If you haven't checked them out at aejuice.com, I highly recommend you do just that right now. Get tons of free plugins from AE Juice that will save time while adding polish and professionalism to your projects. Get the AE Juice Starter Pack, which contains over 100 assets for your projects, including liquid and shape elements, liquid transitions, slides for your slideshows, text presets, flat icons, 2D and 3D assets, and so much more. AE Juice also offers professionally produced sound effects absolutely free. Other free plugins include a HUD package that is super cool. These elements would literally take hours to create, but with AE Juice, you get them absolutely free and they can be dropped into your project with the click of a button. Some of my personal favorite free plugins include Copy Ease, which allows you to copy the speed graph of your keyframes and paste them so you get identical keyframe speeds. I also use Shifter on a regular basis. Instead of going through the multiple steps of offsetting layers, this plugin allows you to do it with the click of a button, which saves a tremendous amount of time. In addition to these
impressive free plugins, you can also purchase advanced products at more than reasonable prices. Take advantage of AE Juice's bundles. My personal recommendation is that you get the I Want It All bundle, which includes everything I just showed you. I've been approached by several sponsors, and I will not promote their products unless I support them, use them, and highly recommend them. AE Juice is an amazing product and company, and in my opinion, it's a necessity for any serious motion graphic designer. AEJuice.com. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-Minute AE merch today at our online store. And sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's guaranteed to make you a shape layer rockstar. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.